Hello and welcome back to another video. I hope you all are doing great. A few weeks back, I had made a mechanical 7-segment display that uses electromagnets to push the segments. The project was so well received, it even got published in Hackspace magazine. I received so many comments and suggestions that I had to make an improved version of it. So thank you everyone. Originally, I had planned to make at least 3 or 4 such digits to display some kind of information on it. The only thing that stopped me from doing it were the power-hungry electromagnets. Thanks to them, each digit draws about 9 amperes. That's a lot. Although providing that much current was not a problem, but I knew it can be a lot better. But then I came across Carl's Flex AR project. It is basically an electromagnet on a flexible PCB. He has made some awesome projects using it. Do check out his work. Anyways, it got me thinking if I could use the same PCB coils to push or pull the segments. This means that I could make the display much smaller and less power hungry. So in this video, I will try to make a few variations of the coils and then test them to see which one works the best. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. Turn your breadboard prototypes into professional looking PCBs. Upload your files and get your PCBs fabricated for just $2. The first thing will be to design a test PCB with few variations of coils. To start with, I am using this flexible actuator as a reference, which is a 2-layer PCB with 35 turns on each layer. Now here comes the difficult part. If you have used KiCad, you may know that KiCad does not allow curved copper traces, only straight traces. But what if we join small straight segments in such a way that it creates a curve? Great. Now continue doing this for a few days till you have one complete coil. But wait, if you look at the PCB file which KiCad generates in a text editor, you can see that each and every segment's position is stored in the form of X and Y coordinates, along with some other information. Any changes here will be reflected in the design as well. Now, what if we could enter all the positions needed to form a complete coil? Thanks to John Spark, he has written a Python script which, after entering few parameters, spits out all the coordinates needed to form a coil. First, I placed a connector on the schematic and wired it like this. This wire will become the coil in the PCB layout. Next, open the Python script using any suitable IDE. You need to set a few parameters like center, number of turns, copper layer, and most importantly, the direction of rotation. While going from one layer to another, the direction must change in order to keep the direction of the current same. Here, -1 represents clockwise, while +1 represents counterclockwise. Run the script and you will be presented with a lot of numbers in the output window. Copy and paste everything into the PCB file and save it. Open the PCB file in KiCad and there's your beautiful coil. Finally, make the remaining connections to the connector and you are done. Check out the instructables if you missed something. Link is in the description below. After I finished designing the board, I sent the Gerber file to JLC PCB and ordered the PCBs. While I wait for the PCBs to arrive, I designed a few test segments in Fusion 360. I scaled down the segment size and reduced the wall thickness, keeping the shape the same as before. I even tested it with different magnet sizes. I found out that a coil with 4 layers and 30 turns on each layer is sufficient. So that's it for this video. In the next video, I will be figuring out the electronics for controlling the segments. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new today. Give a like if you did and make sure you subscribe for more such videos. See you in the next one.